the play?
Oh, I love this play. It's so close to home. The character of the mother reminds me so much of my Jewish grandmother.
Mm-hmm.
She was from New York, and she talked like this, and she was very outspoken, no filter. It's just—it's very close to home, very sitcom-ish, but also at the same time, it touches truth. You know,
mm-hmm.
It touches a reality quite a bit, for me at least.
You?
Yeah.
In what way?
Just because... In life, there's a lot of comedy, and comedy also does come from pain.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes families have those dynamics where, you know, there's things that you're embarrassed about or things that you, you know, cry about and complain about. But at the same time, you go through these rituals every day, and it's what's normal for you. So it's kind of a sense of safety and home being in this environment with this play.
Are you a writer?
I'm not, actually. But my partner is, so.
Okay. Now, how about dealing with this subject? This whole thing has it's a complex collection of stories
mm-hmm.
in this play.
Mm-hmm.
How about whether or not the audience will get all the messages? You think they get them?
I think so. I mean, it's kind of just basically about the family kind of withholding secrets where the mother has no filter, and it's just kind of just, like I said, it's based on truth. I don't know if they'll necessarily get every single tiny thing, but I don't think that's the point. I think the point is just the reality of being in this family and what these people go through on a daily basis. You know, I think if people just come and enjoy and listen, they'll probably get the gist of it and get most of it.
How do you feel about being at the Strand?
I love the Strand. I love this very intimate environment. I love this small theater. I actually prefer smaller spaces to perform, and I've performed in a lot of spaces being in theater and having a degree in theater, but I also have worked in magic, and I was an escape artist, so...
Mm-hmm.
Am an escape artist, but I enjoy these smaller, intimate spaces because it feels like you're bringing them right into the story with you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I enjoy that a lot.
You sound as though you have an accent.
I do.
Yeah.
On stage, I do.
Are you from here?
I actually was born in Illinois, but I've lived in Maryland most of my life. My mom's from Baltimore.
Oh, really?
So.
Have you performed in the other Baltimore theaters here?
Oh, yes. I've done a lot of... I've done community theater as well as professional theater, working in children's theater and touring and working at... I did some shows at Vagabonds and downtown at Spotlighters
mm-hmm.
and, you know, across in Columbia.
Mm-hmm.
I've run the gamut of theater, but it's been about 4 years since I've done a play because I've been doing a lot of filming. I do movie acting.
Particular ones that we can look forward to, or have we seen that didn't know that that was she
Well, yes, actually, there's two films that are going to be coming out soon.
Mm-hmm.
One is called Soulmate, True Evil Never Dies,
mm-hmm.
and we actually recently won 4 awards for it at the WMIFF Festival,
mm-hmm.
which I was really excited about,
right.
And that had to do with Jack the Ripper, and I played a psychic, and it's a psychological thriller, and it's a pretty intense film. And then the other one is called Vampires, Rise of the Fallen, and it's about vampires, and it's kind of an action horror. Kind of like if you take, I don't know, Lost Boys and mix it with, you know, some of the modern vampire tales that are out. Yeah, it's fun. It's a lot of fun.
So, you want to say a shout out to any of the people who are familiar with you here in Baltimore?
Oh gosh. Well, to all my friends and family and fans. I do have a fan site. Hopefully that doesn't sound too pretentious. I love you, and thank you for all of the support, and just keep coming and keep exploring the arts and enjoy every moment in life because it's very short, and so live your life to the fullest and never give up on your dreams.
Yeah, you still are.
Oh, okay. Sorry, I thought that.
Did you ever go to school here?
I did. I went to UMBC.
Okay. In College Park?
No, actually, in Catonsville, at Baltimore County.
Baltimore County.
Mm-hmm. I studied theater there.
So where do you hang out now?
Oh, gosh. Well, next year we're planning on moving to L.A., But as for now, we're kind of just all over the place. You know, I film and do projects wherever I can, whenever I can. I didn't want to miss out on the opportunity to work at the Strand, to work with Rain Pryor, because she was wonderful. We actually did a film last year together. And I don't know, I just try to gain whatever I can from any experience that will help me grow as an actor and as an artist wherever I can.
Did you know that you are in the renamed art district here, where the Strand is?
Yeah, it's really, I love this, how there's, you know, they're building things up, and there's all these theaters, and there's museums, and there's, colleges, and I like that. I think they should bring in more, even more, and build it up even more, because I think sometimes Baltimore can get a bum rap, you know, for not being as artistic. There's a lot of stuff with sports out here, which is fine. I don't have a problem with that. You know, go Orioles, go Ravens, yeah. I do. I think that it's a positive thing. I think people, you know, need to explore the arts and really be proud of creating and finding new things and new opportunities in the area. And I like that.
Have you ever met John, our premier director for a film here?
John Waters?
Yes.
I actually have. Yes. I went to a lecture when I was in college. I went to a lecture, and he was actually, he had laryngitis. So I met him, but he couldn't talk. He was like, you know, but he seemed really nice. And I took a class with Steve Yeager, who's done a documentary with John Waters called Divine Trash.
Mm-hmm.
And it's kind of cool. I felt kind of close to him in that respect because I got to talk to Steve and whatnot.
Well, I don't often get to talk to movie stars. What does it feel like to walk down the red carpet?
Oh, gosh. Surreal. Very surreal, because for years I thought that I was going to do theater. I thought, I'm going to New York. I'm going to do Broadway. This is what I want. And in the last 6 years or so, I found myself kind of haphazardly just kind of coming across film acting. Love it. There's such an intimacy about film, because you don't have to be big, you don't have to be larger than life, you just have to be. And I love stage acting, but film acting for me, it's like a new playground, because it's very true to life and very organic, you know.
Congratulations.
Thank you.